Biatrial enlargement on chest X-ray causing cardiomegaly with the right ventricular pattern of apex, which is lifted up, is discussed here. Right atrial enlargement is evidenced by the shift of the right cardiac border grossly to the right side. Left atrial enlargement is seen as a double contour within the right atrial shadow, that is, shadow within shadow. Please subscribe to this channel for future updates. Click on the subscribe button, press the bell icon after that for all updates. Main pulmonary artery shadow is on the left upper cardiac border. Right hilum is prominent due to the enlargement of the right pulmonary artery. Upper lobe vessels are prominent, known as inverted mustache sign, Stag's Handler sign, and cephalization. Handler sign indicates pulmonary venous hypertension. The article cited in reference 1 gives the picture of a stag with Handler superimposed on the chest X-ray for comparison. The article also lists a non-cardiac cause for Handler sign, lung torsion. It is called cephalization because in normal pulmonary vasculature, lower lobe vessels are more prominent than upper lobe vessels. In pulmonary venous hypertension, there is redistribution of pulmonary blood flow towards the upper lobes, making upper lobe vessels more prominent. Another manifestation of left atrial enlargement is elevation of left bronchus, seen as the air bronchogram on chest X-ray. The upturned apex is suggestive of right ventricular hypertrophy secondary to pulmonary arterial hypertension. Sign which is expected but missing is the third Mughal sign or prominent left atrial appendage below the main pulmonary artery. This can occur if the left atrial appendage had been removed earlier during a closed mitral valvotomy. Left atrial appendage is a common site for thrombus in mitral stenosis and hence used to be removed during closed mitral valvotomy. The surgical procedure is seldom done now because balloon mitral valvotomy is the procedure of choice for symptomatic mitral stenosis. Summarizing the findings, there is evidence of biatrial enlargement, pulmonary venous and arterial hypertension, and right ventricular hypertrophy. Together, these findings can occur in severe mitral stenosis. Down and out, left ventricular type of apex would have been there if there was associated severe mitral regurgitation. Any other cause of long-standing left ventricular inflow obstruction like left ventricular endomyocardial fibrosis can also cause a similar picture. Only echocardiography will reveal the final diagnosis. Associated tricuspid regurgitation secondary to severe pulmonary hypertension is likely in view of right atrial enlargement. Here is a relevant journal reference on Handler sign. Please don't forget to subscribe to this channel for future updates and click on the bell icon for all updates. Thank you.